Good afternoon and welcome to this explainer video. You must be wondering what this explainer video is all about. This is basically to get you acquainted with all the rules and regulations that you have to keep in mind while playing the preliminary rounds of CHQ 2021. Thank you for registering in large numbers for this quiz. We are indeed proud to have more than 20,000 students from across the nation and even overseas to take part in this quiz, a unique one on Indian heritage and culture. We are very excited to see that all the young minds are so excited about this wonderful topic. Now, we'll have to take you through the process on how you have to proceed for the preliminary rounds. Now, first, you started the journey with registering, and I'm sure a lot of you have been playing our daily quizzes as well. Now, the preliminary round starts from 12th of November, okay? And to start off with the preliminary round, one thing that you need to be aware of is your cluster. So since we have a huge number of students from all across the country and different cities, we have divided India into 18 clusters. And each of these clusters has a focus city. So what are these clusters? The clusters are Chennai. So it's not only for schools in Chennai, but schools in Chennai, Pondicherry, Andaman and Nicobar Islands, and also Lakshadweep will be included in this cluster. We have Coimbatore, which basically talks about the rest of Tamil Nadu except Chennai. We have the Bengaluru cluster, which is for schools in Bengaluru. We have the Mysore cluster, which is for the rest of Karnataka except Mangalore. We have the Kochi cluster, which is basically for the state of Kerala. So all the schools from Kerala will be taking part in the Kochi cluster. We have the Hyderabad cluster, which is basically for all schools in Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. We have the Kolkata cluster, which is basically for all the schools in West Bengal. We have the Guwahati cluster, which basically refers to the northeastern states, Assam, Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram, Arunachal Pradesh, Tripura, Meghalaya, and Sikkim. All of these states would be included in the Guwahati cluster. We have the Bhubaneswar cluster, which is for schools in Odisha. We have the Jamshedpur cluster for Bihar and Jharkhand students. We have the Pune cluster, which is basically for students in Maharashtra, except the ones in Mumbai and Navi Mumbai. We have the Mumbai cluster, which basically is for students from Mumbai, Goa, Daman and Diu, and Dadra and Nagar Haveli, and of course, Navi Mumbai. We have the Indore cluster, which is for schools from Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. We have the Ahmedabad cluster, which is for schools in Gujarat. We have the Delhi cluster, which is for students from Delhi, of course, Jammu and Kashmir, Ladakh, and also students who have registered from overseas. We have the Chandigarh cluster, which is for students from Punjab and Haryana. We have the Jaipur cluster, which is for students from Rajasthan. We have the Lucknow cluster, which is for students from UP and Uttarakhand. So in case you don't belong to these focus cities, don't worry, you're still in the cluster that I explained very well. So for example, if you are a student from Rajasthan and you stay in Udaipur or Jodhpur, you'll be in the Jaipur cluster. Or if you are a student from, say, Amritsar, you'll be in the Chandigarh cluster. Okay, so that's how it will work. To increase the engagement between us, what we have done is conceptualize the preliminary round into a 4-stage event. So each of you will get the chance to attempt 4 preliminary quizzes. The first 2 preliminary quizzes, which will be held on the 12th and 13th, the first preliminary quiz, in fact, which will be held on the 12th and 13th, is basically a common set which has questions across the general area of Indian heritage, and all the clusters will get common questions. The second preliminary round is, of course, on the 14th and the 15th, which is again a common test based on Indian heritage. On 16th and 17th, we have the third preliminary round where you will get a question pertaining to your cluster. Say, for example, if you are in a student from Tezpur in Assam, you'll get questions which are pertaining to the northeast of India. So that particular preliminary round will be based on the northeast of India, which will cover all the states in your cluster. It will cover, it will have questions which are related to Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram, Arunachal Pradesh, Tripura, Meghalaya, Sikkim, and the northeast in general. Then once again, on the 18th and the 19th, we have another localized cluster set where the questions are going to be from your cluster only or focused on your cluster only. Please note that during this whole stage, there is no elimination from the first preliminary to the second preliminary to the third preliminary. All of you who have registered for the Cycle Heritage Quiz 2021 will get a chance to play in all these four preliminary rounds. The exact time of your preliminary round or each of these preliminary rounds and your respective cluster will be emailed to you by us. Remember, for each of the quizzes, you'll have a 30-minute window in which to attempt these quizzes. So for example, if your date is on 12th of November, the quiz may start at 11 a.m. 11 to 11:30 is basically the time window in which you can start your quiz, all right? But you have to complete each quiz by 15 minutes. There will be a timer on screen, which I will explain to you later on. And we'll be accepting entries only from people who have completed each of the quizzes in less than 15 minutes. All right. So the top six students in each cluster will qualify for the cluster finals, which is going to be held live on video call and will be hosted by me, your quiz master, Hitash Banerjee. And then the cluster finals, again, whose schedule will be intimated to you later on, will lead on to the national quarterfinals, then the national semifinals, and then the grand finale to crown India's heritage champion. All right, so now it is time for me to show you how to go about playing this preliminary round. So what I'll do right now is share my screen. So along with the mail that intimates you about the schedule of your preliminary rounds, you will also get a link. The link to play a particular preliminary round. Say for example, here it is written CHU Daily Quiz 64. Don't be confused on that. In normal cases, when we send you the link and you click on that link, you will see it's written as CHU preliminaries, common set, say Mysore cluster. Or your cluster name will be mentioned, whether it's a common set or whether it's a localized set, that will also be mentioned on the top of the screen. Also, in our mail, we would be letting you know the exact time to attempt your quiz. All right. So you have to open that particular link that we have sent you through the mail only at the time mentioned in the email. So for example, if we have told you that your preliminary round one starts from 11 a.m., please do not open this link before 11 a.m. Because if you do so, you'll find that the link is closed. Okay? And you don't want that situation, right? Also, please note, each person is allowed to attempt each of the four preliminaries only once. So you have to attempt the first preliminary once, second preliminary once, third preliminary once, and the fourth preliminary once. All right? And yes, then just ignore the rules here. I'll tell you the fresh rules that are going to be in place for the preliminary. The preliminary round, each of the preliminary quizzes will have 20 questions. Each question will have four options, with one of them being the correct answer. There's going to be 1 point per correct answer. While attempting the quiz, you'll also see a timer on screen. Okay, the timer will track how much time you have taken to attempt the quiz. So for example, if you have started at 11 p.m. and you finish the quiz at 11:13 p.m., it will show you on screen that 13 minutes will show a timer. Please note that in the interest of fairness, we will accept only entries which come to us within 15 minutes. So of course, if your time slot is from 11 a.m. to 11:30 p.m., you can start the quiz at 11:15 a.m. also. But make sure that you submit the forms or you submit this quiz by 11:30 a.m. Also, in case you have started at 11:05 a.m., please make sure that you finish the quiz by 11:20 a.m. Okay, easy enough. Now, most important part. You know that all of you would be given certificates for playing this quiz, right? And I'm sure you're very excited about that. But in order for us to send you the certificates, you need to help us out also. You need to tell us your right name with the correct spelling that you would like to be mentioned on the certificate. And most importantly, you have to mention the correct email ID. This email ID that you put here will have to be the exact same email ID by which you have registered. So if you can see, you have a place to enter your first name. Ignore the fill in Facebook part. Don't worry about that. Just ignore that. But put in your first name, put in your last name as per your correct spelling, and put in your email ID. My name is Titash, so I will put Titash here. I'm not putting Titash Banerjee here. I'm putting only my first name here. I'm putting Banerjee here, okay, which is my surname. I'm putting my email address here. This is titash@theanspace.com. This is my exact correct email address. Okay. And please, you have to enter the same email address with which you registered, because that is how we'll be tracking. And of course, there are so many students who have registered for this quiz. So you don't want us to disqualify you for any unfortunate errors. Or we also want each and every one of you to get your certificates, right? So please, I request you, please be very aware of your email ID and enter the correct email ID, the ones with which you have registered. So don't worry if the one with which you have registered is your parents' email ID. That's fine. You can enter that only. Okay. So please make sure that the email ID is same as the one with which you have registered. So whatever you have entered as your email ID, please put that. So now let's get started with the quiz. So now you have entered your name, first name, last name, and your email ID. Now we click on get started. So it takes some time to load. Just have patience. So you will see a question here. You also see the label of the quiz, what quiz it is. At the right-hand side bottom corner, you see the timer which is running. So you have a question here. How do we better know Devavrata in the Mahabharata? Pretty easy one, right? So the answer is Bhishma. So what do? You click on Bhishma, okay? Or whatever you feel is the correct answer. And you click on continue, okay? Okay, one difference that you will see from this particular daily quiz to your final quiz is, in this case, we are showing you the answer because, of course, it's more of a fun interaction. But in the final quiz, you would not get to see the answer. You would click on the screen, say Bhishma, and then click on continue. Only when you click on continue will your answer be registered. Okay. So next, we move to this question, who is known for his famous painting Bharat Mata. You click on Gaganendranath Tagore. Again, during the final quiz, we won't show you whether your answer is right or wrong. So I'll just move on. So you will have some visual questions in between as well. And in case the visuals take some time to load, please have patience. Don't worry, it will load within 3 or 4 seconds. In case you are on a not so fast internet connection, but frankly speaking, the bandwidth required for this quiz is not much. So Just have some patience and the questions will definitely load. All right. So, and the air in the final one, it will be 20 questions, not 10 questions. And yes, you might have a link which says post on Facebook, share link. Please, please do not click on that link. We are going to be tracking that as well. That whether are you putting the link on Facebook or you sharing the link, please do not do that. Okay. Otherwise, we might have to take some action. We'll also mention that in the rules as well. Please, please do not click on post on Facebook or share link in case it appears. All right. So this is how you will play the quiz. There's going to be 20 questions. Okay. At the end, you will see your score, of course, not the cumulative score, your score for that particular preliminary round. Okay. And the answers to that preliminary round will, of course, be revealed after 2 days. Once every cluster has played its preliminary round, only then will the answers be revealed to you. Okay. So that's how the quiz is going to work. Okay. And we'll, of course, send you a detailed email with all the rules. We'll send you, of course, your cluster, obviously, the link to play the quiz. So this is just a short primer on how to attempt preliminary rounds of CHU 2021.